evening, family and friends. Greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And welcome to the virtual celebration of our beloved friend and brother, Troy Douglas Clark. We have united from far and near to celebrate the life of this bright light who is yet shining bright in our hearts, who has gone from labor to his heavenly reward.
That's right, Dr. Judy. We are honored tonight to pay tribute and to give thanks for the life and for the legacy of Troy Douglas Clark and for the time that we were blessed to have him here with us on earth. As we can see, people from the industry and from all around the country have come from the north, the south, the east, and the west to pay tribute to Troy on tonight. And even though this is one of the most difficult things that I've had to do in quite some time, I can do so tonight with the full assurance that to be absent from the body, we know that Troy is present with the Lord. And we have not lost him because we know exactly where he is.
The scripture admonishes us in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 18, "In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you." Notice that the scripture did not say for everything, but certainly in everything we do give thanks. We are commanded to do so. And Dr. Pugh, that's exactly what we're going to do on this evening. In the midst of sorrow, we will give thanks. In the midst of hurt, we will give thanks. In the midst of all of the questions that we all have, we will give thanks. Not only is this what God commands us to do, but it is certainly what Troy would have wanted us to do.
Absolutely. And what do we say to these things? We know, though, that somehow God will still get the glory, and we'll tell the story.
My personal reflection of Troy, I met him in 1990, right about the time when we were getting praise and worship off the ground at the West Angeles Church. And he was a part of one of the first praise teams. Before the praise team came before the congregation back then, you know, in our churches, particularly in our Pentecostal churches, we didn't really do praise and worship the way that we do it today. And so I had a whole year, a series of teachings on praise and worship for 52 Monday nights before they had the opportunity to stand before the congregation. I had the honor of teaching a select few individuals, and Troy was at every single time of instruction. That struck me so very deeply, and it resonated with my heart, to the point that when I had the opportunity to do my recording and every recording subsequently after that, Troy was certainly a part of that time. We forged such a relationship. His birthday is a few days before mine, and every single year I would call him on his birthday, and then a few days later he would call me on my birthday. And I'll let you in on something. We used to call each other Old Bat. That's how I would answer the phone. I said, "Okay, Old Bat, how you doing?" And he'd say, "I'm good, Old Bat." We just had such a wonderful time. And certainly my heart was broken when I heard of the passing of my dear friend. But I'm so glad to know that he is in a better place. And I had the opportunity to speak with him on this, his birthday, and he shared with me some of the struggles that he was experiencing. But I'm so thankful to God that he's out of pain, he's out of misery, and he is with the Lord. Thank God for the life of Troy Clark.
Wow, that was powerful. Well, Dr. Judy, my personal reflection of Troy would go all the way back to the year 2006, New Year's Eve. It was about 4 o'clock in the evening, and I had gotten a call from my family saying that my mother had, she had coded a couple of times, and they were gonna try one more time. And eventually they did call back, and she coded and passed away suddenly. and very unexpectedly. And I told Troy, I said, I just feel like we had a concert to do for New Year's Eve, just hours later. And I told him, I just feel like I want to just cancel my evening, get into bed, just, you know, I just want to be by myself. And he said, I'm sorry. I said, I want to cancel my evening. He said, absolutely not. What we're going to do is what we always do. We're going to offer up a sacrifice. This is the perfect time to offer up a sacrifice. He said, a sacrifice. I remember just like it was yesterday, a sacrifice always involves death. And so what you've got to allow yourself to do is you got to put your hurt and your pain and your tears and your disappointment, and you got to sacrifice all of that on the altar so that you can then give God what is still due his name, which is the highest praise. And so even tonight, as we're faced with the reality of Troy's departure, we have to do just that. And that is to render unto God what is due his name. That is what Troy would want us to do. And so that's what we're doing tonight as we offer up all of these amazing tributes.
Each one that knew Troy had a story. Each one has a reflection. And tonight we have joined forces with friends and loved ones from across the nation to pay tribute to Troy.
So on behalf of countless souls who were impacted by Troy's life, tonight we send light, life, and love to the bereaved family. To Mother Sandra Clark, we love you. To his two beautiful sisters, Tutu and Tracy. To Auntie Nessa, Auntie Ann, and Auntie Carla, thank y'all so much for sharing Troy with us. Our lives have forever been changed because of his life.
Yes, we love you, family, and you will ever remain in our prayers. Before we start our tributes, let's briefly chronicle some key events in Troy's journey.
Troy Douglas Clark, 1967 to 2020. The son, the brother, the talent manager, the talent. Born as the son of Dexter Clark, deceased, and Sandra Clark on September 27, 1967, in Glendale, California, raised in Altadena, California. Troy began his spiritual journey at a very early age. By his teenage years, he became an active member of West Angeles, where he quickly found a place as an active member in the music department under the leadership of Kurt Carr and Dr. Judith McAllister. According to Kurt Carr, Troy was the first one to publicly sing the lead to his smash hit song, For Every Mountain. Carr shared, after Troy ministered the song, Bishop Blake was unable to preach that Sunday, and he strongly suggested that Carr record the song. And the rest was history. Troy's love and passion for music led him to lend his talents to a couple of groups in the LA area, the first being Higher Dimension, that evolved into an all-male group later renamed Volume 3. This particular group was signed by Sony Records in 1992. After the record deal ran its course, Troy pivoted to the executive side of the industry. In the early 1990s, he landed an A&R job with Gospel Centric Records, where he served under the CEO, Vicky Lateod. During his tenure, he obtained a wealth of knowledge and experience about the inner workings of the music industry, and he worked closely with acts such as God's Property, Lawrence Matthews, Kurt Carr and the Kurt Carr Singers, Byron Cage, and many more. Troy's tenure, combined with his years of experience at the Screen Actors Guild, sparked a great passion and interest for artist development, which led him to establish Clark Management in 2002, where he nurtured a very diverse roster of artists such as B. Slade, Ernest Pugh, Octavia Pace, Charles Butler and Trinity, and others. One of his favorite pastimes, away from his duties and responsibilities as a full-time manager, was traveling on the road with his best friend, R&B sensation, Stephanie Mills.
This is my best friend in the world, Bishop Troy. Come on, baby.
Will be greatly missed by countless souls that he impacted with his warm heart, smile, humor, and remarkable talent. He leaves to mourn his passing a beloved mother, Miss Sandra Clark of Altadena, California, two beautiful sisters, Tracy Clark and Tanitra Clark, also of Altadena, California, several aunts, uncles, a host of nieces and nephews, and cousins.
Vicki MacLeod, and I'm here to pay tribute to a great friend and just one of the funniest guys I've ever known, Troy Clark. Troy was the longest running employee at Gospel Centric and Be Right, and when he just came in, he lit up the room. And so I'd like to tell you a funny story about Troy. There were so many, but one day Troy went to go get Roscoe's chicken and waffles for the whole office. There were about 10 or 15 of us in the office. And we got, you know, oxtails and giblets and just chicken, of course, waffles, and just a lot of heavy food. And he brought it back, and I can't remember who he was with, but he brought it back, and we ate the food, had a good time, and then Troy was, I remember very clearly, just laying on the couch going, "Whew, I'm tired. I need to go home." And I looked at him and I said, "Troy, I'm tired too. Let's go home." It was 1 o'clock in the afternoon. We were full of soul food, couldn't move, and we cut work for the rest of the day because we were too full. And every time I saw Troy, we would talk about one of those funny stories. And so that was my funny Roscoe's chicken and waffles story with Troy. Troy, I'm gonna miss him, and I just talked to him recently. We've talked all the time. And Troy, I just wanna tell him, don't make the angels laugh too hard. I'm gonna miss you. Thank you.
Back in 2007, about 13 years ago, I got a call while I was in Memphis from Troy Clark. We were there during the 100-year Kojic anniversary. And he called me, asked me if he could set up a meeting with a client of his. And I said, okay, no problem. So we set it up. But the next day, I had a lunch meeting with Brother Troy, and he introduced me to Ernest Pugh. And from that meeting, we produced Ernest's number one record, I believe, is Rain on Us, the following year. And we followed up with another number one record, I Need Your Glory. And I just want to say, from that, I'm grateful to God that Troy set that meeting up. and started my friendship and brotherhood with Brother Ernest. You know, Troy, he and I never really had interactions, like close interactions like that, but every time I would see him, be it at church or on a road with artists or what have you, he was always fun. His spirit was always light. And he just made the energy of the room just be peaceful, you know? And so I thank God for that. You know, the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 22, verse 1, a good name is rather to be chosen than riches. You know, in a world where people stab you in the back for fame, for money, in church where people will stab you in the back for fame and money, Troy has always been consistent. And he looked out for his people. And I'm grateful to God for that. So I just want to say, Troy, we love you. I thank you for being the man that you were. You were very consistent. You never changed. And I thank God for that. Troy, we're going to miss you. Rest in peace, my brother. You have affected a lot of people with your love. God bless you.
So lonely, feeling so down when you need someone, no one's there to be found. The pain inside can't be expressed verbally, so you cry on your pillow. You don't know what you're saying, but I know an interpreter of tears. When your voice you cry, it lends an open ear. Oh, God understands the language of tears. He knows all about all your pain and your fears. When you're right and you're wrong, when your friends are gone, he's a shoulder to cry on. You can't keep it bottled inside, so just let it out, out. In God you confide. That's what he's there for. He knows all your pain. It's alright to cry. Joy will come in the morning, but I know interpreter. When your voice will cry, he lives in open ear. Oh, God understands the language of your tears. He knows all about all your pains and your fears. When you're right and you're wrong, when your friends are gone, he's a shoulder to cry. Shoulder to cry on. God understands your tears. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yes.
He knows all about your pain. Oh, yes, he does. He understands. Your tears, it's all right to cry. Oh, Jesus, you can cry on him, 'cause he understands your pain. Lay your head on the master, he knows all about it.
understand your tears. It's all right to cry over dreams we often forfeit, over needless pains we bear, all because we do not carry everything to God and everything to God and everything, everything to God in prayer. He understands your tears, you're gonna do now, but he says I'm here right now for you. God understands the language of tears. He knows all about all your pain and your fears. When you're right and you're wrong,
He's a child
to cry on. God understands your tears. Oh, he understands your tears, yeah. Oh, yes, he does. He knows all about your struggles, till the day is done. Cry on Jesus. He understands the language of tears. Oh, yes, he does. Your tears are salted by design. Give your soul its proper enzymes. He's baptizing you. He's reminding you. Language of tears.
We would now be blessed with tributes from some incredible friends of Troy.
Troy was one of the most humble, genuine guys in the game. If he rocked with you, you had a friend indeed. Prayers up for the entire family and friends.
To have to say bye to a friend that you've had for over 20 years is hard, but to have to say bye to a friend like Troy Clark is even harder. Troy and I met when we were working on When the Music Starts. Music Stops by Daryl Coley. We were working from different aspects. I worked for the label and he was one of the singers. And then from there, we started working together at Gospel Centric. And then from there, a relationship that was birthed that would never end. And we were great friends, great buddies, great. We worked together, great workers together. We were great supporters of each other after we no longer worked there. And we've just been great friends forever. Troy loved his family. He loved his mama and his sisters and his nieces and nephews. And he just was a great guy to hang out with and to fellowship with. And to know that he's gone is a hard thing to do and to accept. But we're going to do it and move forward. I don't know who's going to finish my gospel-centric stories when we have to imitate Vicky, but I'll try to carry on in his stead. But I loved him, and I always will love him, and I just appreciate the fact that we're doing this wonderful tribute to him because it's so much and so deserved. I know he'll be watching, and I believe that the Lord is going to allow him to see this and to know just how much he was loved and appreciated, and this will be like a hug to him from us, so... I love you, Black.
What can I say about my friend Troy? There really isn't enough time to describe all that he means to me. He is my dearest friend. Not just a friend, he's a brother. was a person that was so great and so humble, and we shared so much as friends. I learned so much from him. He taught me about music, reminded me to trust God in times of difficulty. He showed me what it is to love and love unconditionally. And I could always count on him to make me laugh. He was and still is such a vital part of my life. I will continue to carry all the love and memories we shared as friends. Mama, Tracy, Tutu, Auntie Ann, Auntie Nessa, Auntie Carla, and the entire family, thank you for embracing me and welcoming me into your family. Thank you for sharing the gift that is Troy with all of us. And thank you, Troy, for being my friend.
Up next is one of the lead singers of the Kurt Carr Singers and one of the lead worship leaders here at West Angeles Church of God in Christ, pastored by Bishop Charles E. Blake Sr., Miss Nikki Potts, followed by more tributes.
Good evening, everyone. I would like to say a few words about my brother, our friend, our brother, Troy Clark. I met Troy many, many years ago when I was a teen, and we sang together, we laughed together, we praise God together. We shared special moments. And we are all going to miss Troy's laughter, Troy's jokes and gestures. To Troy's mom, thank you for sharing your son with the world. He was a great guy, a great brother, and he is already missed. Thank you, family, for sharing your uncle, your brother, your cousin with us. God's timing is not our timing. God knows and is in control. And I know Troy gave God glory for everything that he did. And I know God welcomed him with open arms, and he's resting in Jesus. So I just want to share this short rendition of To God Be the Glory. To God be the glory, to God be the glory, to God be the glory for the things he has done with his blood. And by his power, he has raised me. Oh, to God be the glory for the things, for the marvelous things, for all the things. The things that he has done, he has done. We love you, Troy.
Troy, when I think of you, I think of joy. You always had a smile on your face. You could always make others laugh. You were gifted, strong, and brave, but you didn't wear it. You didn't share everyone that you met or had worked with, but instead, you were loyal and didn't mind building others up. The years we worked together at Gospel Centric Records were awesome. I will never forget when I contacted you to bring Stephanie Mills to Cincinnati and you made it happen for me. The concert was amazing and seeing you was the icing on the cake. Take your rest, Troy. And thanks for bringing me and so many others joy.
Hey everybody, this is Jamil Headliner Green, the CEO of the Headliner Agency. I am humbled to be able to talk about my good friend, Troy Clark. If you ever come in contact with Troy, you know that there was two things that you were gonna learn about him. He was honest and he was funny. Troy did not hold words. He was very honest, he was very true. He said what he meant and he meant what he said. I am grateful for the years of knowing Troy, all the life lessons that he has taught me. I started the Headliner Agency because of Troy Clark. He was one of the first people to give me the okay, to give me the go, to stand with me and be in support of me. And I'll forever cherish the moments, the knowledge, the wisdom that he poured into me. I'm continuously praying for his family. I love you so much, Troy. I'll always miss you.
Troy, my dearest godson, words cannot express how much I and the Coley family miss you. You have brought so much joy to us. Always smiling, no matter what the trial or challenge that had come your way. Your voice, your smile, your character, your presence, you are missed. To the Clark family, we are praying for you. Remember, tears are cleansing and a release of the pressure of sorrow. God will carry you through. Troy lives in us forever and through our memories. He is never gone, always and forever.
Brace yourself, ladies and gentlemen, for the dynamic Chaz Shepherd, followed by tributes from Troy's industry friends.
Shalom. In the late 90s, Troy called and said, Chaz, I'd like to record a song just for me to have, just a solo, and I'd like it to be a song by Journey, a hit group. And I said, come on, man, let's do it. How cool. It was an honor. As I've always loved Troy's voice and his ability and his control and his sound, his tone. And in celebration of our friendship, of our consistent love toward one another, us just laughing and joking and hugging, and if we were in different towns, meeting up in whatever town we would both cross through at the same time, you know what I mean, and do the same thing over and over again, man, in celebration of sharing a good portion of this life with a great soul. And again, as I said, constant love. I'd like to do a little bit of that song that he did in that high key. Amen, that he did it. You know, Indians have high voices. And so maybe that's why he could hit those notes. He'll always be Indian to me, amen? Anyway, let's go back to the days when I had to meet him on Melrose at the shop. Anybody remember those days? I love Troy Clark.
Now I come to you with open arms, nothing to hide. Believe what I say. What your love means to me, open arms. strong. Hold on. Hold on. Yeah. You're trying.
Live now, not later. I love Troy Clark.
I've been going back and forth on what to say in this video because I'm still in shock that I lost my brother, my friend, Troy Clark. Troy, from the first day we met years ago, he was always just a bright light and just positive and funny and just a great supporter of me as a person and as a professional. And it meant so much to me. You know, he was one of the first people I remember getting a birthday text from this year and just celebrate me like he typically would, just and congratulate me on all the great things. And I'm gonna miss him. Troy Clark was just a class act. He would give you the shirt off of his back, and he was going to be greatly missed. My brother Troy, I love you. I'm still wrapping my mind around it, but I know God is in control, but I miss you, bro.
Hello, I'm John Murray, and I'm proud to say that Troy Clark was my friend. I met Troy through Neely Dickerson, and when I would travel to LA on business, we spent many hours at Roscoe's Chicken and Waffles. Now listen, I would get fresh off the plane and hit Troy and Neely and say, meet me at Roscoe's. And they'd meet me there and tell me about the glory days of gospel-centric. And we'd be loud and laughing and cutting up. And Troy could tell a story, man. He'd have you cracking up laughing. Well, he also would make you tell him a couple of good ones because that infectious laugh of his, he loved to laugh. He loved to have fun. I'm going to miss answering my phone and Troy saying, hey, buddy. I don't know if he did that when he called everybody, but that's how he always greeted me. And on holidays, you know, every significant holiday, Troy would always check in, see how you were doing. And when you'd ask how he was doing, he'd say, I'm over my mother's house cutting up, about to go home soon. We just eating and having a good time because Troy loved his family. And Miss Sandra, he loved you a lot, so much so he was so concerned about you going to church at the beginning of this pandemic. And so I sat on the phone with him a few times on three-way. When he called the non-emergency number for the police because he wanted them to come shut your church services down. But he only did that because he loved you. And I told him, I said, Troy, you got to give it to him good. Act like one of those Karens. And so he said, if my sister calls me, I know the police showed up. The police never did, by the way. But Troy loved his family, Tracy and Tutu. He loved all of you all. And so thank you for sharing Troy with us. Troy was a great friend. And we're going to miss him so, so much. So, Troy, we love you, brother, and we'll see you on the other side.
My friend Troy, words can't express the hole that I feel in my heart right now. The one thing I thank God for, our 33 years of friendship, of laughs, of relationship. You will call me your sister, I call you my brother. I'm so grateful to have had you in my life and to have had you close in my life for many, many years of traveling, the singing, the church singing and concerts, midnight musicals, and just so many memories, birthdays, my children, you know, graduations and, you know, parties and just so much that I thank God that we were able to share. This one you kept from me, so I didn't know anything severe was going on, but I love you and I will gravely miss you. And I just want to say that your laughter, your calling me Shaka at any given moment, me calling you my Abib, just, you know, I'll never forget the many, many things that we shared, and the every other or every 2 or 3 weeks conversations we would have. We would keep in touch and just talk. I call you out the blue and say something, one of our private jokes, and you would fall out laughing and say, "Sure, you're so stupid." No, we just laugh and just reminisce, but those talks won't happen anymore. And that in and of itself is enough to really, really put a hole in my soul. So I love you, Troy. You will forever be in my heart. And I'm gonna gravely miss you, brother. And I know that you're resting in the arms of the Lord, because I know you loved God. And I know that you're with your Heavenly Father. And that gives some peace to know that. But I miss you, and I will always, always hold you close in my heart. And I thank your mom and your sisters for sharing you and allowing me to call you brother. So I, along with many, 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 many of your friends, want to say that I love you and I'll miss you forever, my brother, my Abib. I love you, Troy.
The fabulous Crystal Rucker will now share a moving tribute and, of course, more heartfelt tributes.
Thank you, Jesus. I long to be a beast. Life has taught to say all is well with me. I'll trust in you. What may my faith in you? Keep it wherever I go. Your
Pastor Nalanda Love here from Pasadena, California. Greetings to brothers and sisters in the Lord, those in California and across the nation. I'm expressing my sincere condolences at the passing of my little brother, Troy Clark. Such an unexpected thing. But we never know from day to day what is going to happen. My heart is absolutely breaking at this loss, sudden loss, as I know so many of you are. Many of us have sang with Troy over the years, have been friends with him in Altadena and Pasadena. Our kids have known him, our neighbors have known him. He is just a joyous human being. And so to Sandra and his sisters and close relatives and friends, I say, God bless you with peace, with comfort and strength, knowing that indeed we will see Troy again. Donnie Roberts led a group many years ago, Unity and Harmony, and Troy and I and many of us sang in that group, and we just had such joy in our souls for the Lord. And Troy was so joyous. He was funny, he was happy, he was smart, he was friendly, he was loving, he was all that. And so he will truly be missed. So I say, God bless you and take good care. May his face shine upon you.
Hi everyone,
I am Shanika Burrell, and I had to say something about Troy Clark. I called him my brother. I met Troy, I was 18, and I was in a gospel choir, God's Property, and Troy worked at the record label, Gospel Centric, Be Right. And every time I was always out in LA, I would go in his office, harass him and Gretchen Newbel. Harass Troy and Gretchen Newbel. Never failed. Then I decided to move to Los Angeles and started going to West Angeles, and lo and behold, that was Troy's home church as well. I didn't even know Troy could sing. Like all those years prior to me moving out here, I didn't even know brother could sing and brother could sing. So anyway, I just wanted to tell you, Troy, you know, I love you. I love you. I'm going to miss you. I'm going to try not to cry. You were always so positive. I mean, Troy was never messy, just always goofy, always encouraging, always, you know, saying, you can do this. Why you can't move out here, girl? Always talking about, you know, making some type of noise, some type of face. And I'm really sad that you are gone. I prayed a selfish prayer and was like, God, I know he's yours. First, forever, and always. But please, God, can we get just a little bit more time? And God said, I want my son home. So he called him home. So Troy, I'm going to miss you. I'm going to continue to be goofy and cut up when I get around David and Fred and Ernest and, you know, the brethren. I just love you, and may you rest in peace.
First and foremost, I would like to send love to Troy's family. Our thoughts and prayers are with you through this difficult time. Wow, I can't believe you're gone. What a special person Troy was. That was my homeboy. Lord, what a good time we had back in the day. Our gospel-centric times was crazy. We made great music and had lots of fun doing it. Some of my crazy moments was with Troy on the road, at the office, studio, anywhere, everywhere. We was always doing something. So many moments. Troy was so sweet. That beautiful smile was infectious. He was also a hard worker. He was kind, willing to help. Oh, he knows his stuff. In the background, making it happen. And he can sing his face off. The artist loved him. Funny story. Neely reminded me the other day, the crazy, crazy, crazy time we crashed D'Angelo's VIP section at the House of Blues. We wanted to watch the show from upstairs, so we busted into the VIP area. Troy was so nervous, kneeling in heels. I was laughing, talking fast, and we was like, keep walking and act like you're supposed to be here. Man, oh man. We laughed, danced, sang, and had a great time. He was like, y'all crazy. And guess what? So was he, hanging out with me and Neely. That Troy was always down for a good time. The last time I saw him was at the Stephanie Mills show. I was so glad to see him, whereas I hadn't seen him in a while, because I don't live in LA anymore. So it had been a minute, and he was still smiling from ear to ear. Those special moments of him will always make me smile. Rest in peace, my friend. God bless.
We will now be blessed with a selection from one of Troy's great friends. She's also a worship leader at West Angeles Church of God in Christ. Ladies and gentlemen, the amazing Miss Toya Adams. And oh yes, more tributes coming right up afterwards.
To my friend, Troy, I just wanted to take this moment to be able to express to you how much I love you and how much you mean to me. I find courage in knowing that you knew that when you were here. But I wanted to take this moment to express it and to say to the family and your mom and your sister that we are praying for you and holding you up. Thank you so much, as so many people probably will express. Thank you for sharing your precious Troy with us. We are so honored to have had him as a part of our lives, as we've laughed and loved with him. And we just want you to be encouraged. You don't have to worry. And don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning. Troubles, they won't last always. For there's a friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And when your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No matter what may come my way, my life is in your hands. With him I know I can stand. No matter what may come my way, no matter what may come my way, no matter what may come my way, my life is in God's hand. My life is in
been in the business a while, you meet incredible people who have a lasting impression on you. Troy was definitely one of those people. He had a way of making you feel like family. Every time we saw each other, we'd crack up laughing about the early days. The world and I will miss him dearly.
You know, when I think about it, that was not a day that went by over the last probably 25 years that Troy and I did not talk or text. And so this is a very difficult time, but I want to take this moment to really encourage the family, to Mama Sandra, to aunties, Ann and Nessa and Carla, to Tutu and Tracy. Listen, we got to hold on to God's unchanging hand, because one thing about it, we know we will see Troy again. So let this encourage your heart. Hold to God's unchanging hand. He'll never leave us and he'll never forsake us.
In times like these, we got to hold on to God's unchanging hand. A God that'll never leave us and never forsake us. Come on, wherever you are, put your hands on it. Listen.
I misfeel swift transition. Yeah. Not on earth, honeymoon can stand.
Here's what you gotta do.
Build your hopes on things eternal. Hold to God's unchanging hand. Hold on and never let go. Hold on and never let go.
go. I want to say a second verse here. Listen. Trust in him who'll never leave you. Whatsoever the years may bring, I had to learn this for myself. That if I earthly prince forsaken, feel closer to him clinging. Hold on and never let go. Hold on and never let go. Now right here, I need to make me a mass choir. Everybody help me say, everybody just
hold to
come on.
His hand.
God's unchanging.
God's unchanging.
Oh, oh.
Hold to his hand.
God's unchanging.
God's unchanging hand.
We gotta
feel
your hope on things
eternal.
Everybody hold,
To God's unchanging hand.
Come on, if you're holding, I need you clapping. Come on, wherever you are, lift your hands together. Let's say that one more time. Everybody say, hey.
Hold to his hand.
God's unchanging
hand.
God's unchanging.
God's unchanging hand.
We gotta
feel
hope on things
eternal.
So everybody hold
on to God's unchanging hand.
Yeah. Come on, let's go to church right here. Hey, hold to his hand. Everybody hold on. If everybody holding on, then let me see you wave your hand. Listen, the race is not given
to
the swift or strong. It's given to the one that I
hold.
Hey, hold on. Hey, come on, clap them. Everybody hold. Listen, I cannot trust the sweetest train, but holy lane,
hold
Jesus' name. Hey, hold on,
hold on,
hold on,
hold on,
hold on,
hold on,
through the storm, through the rain, through sickness and pain. Hey, everybody holding on. Sometimes, but stand on the very word of God. He'll never, never, never leave you. And never, never, never forsake you. Hey, hold on.
Hold on.
When you're down, when you're out, when you're tossed
on
the ground, don't let nothing separate you from the love. Hold on. Hey,
feel your something
so everybody hold
to
God's unchanging
hand.
Hey, hey,
hand. Hey, this is Kurt Carr. And this is very difficult for me to do because Troy Clark was one of my dearest friends. I actually can't even remember when I didn't know Troy. I cannot remember when we met. We've just known each other forever. We've been brothers, and that boy has made me laugh. I mean, more than anybody ever. Troy was a light. Every room he walked in, he illuminated that room. He did a lot of recording sessions with me, and a lot of people mistake him for Troy Bright. He's not Troy Bright, he's Troy Clark. And every session that he's ever did with me, if I brought in a new person, by the end of the night, the new person was his best friend. Troy was just like that. He just warmed up to everybody and just like was a light in any dark place. He was a light. I remember even the last time we talked a few weeks ago, he didn't sound like himself. He was down, but we still had our laugh and our joke. And the last words Troy ever said to me was, I love you.
And we never really said that to each other, but I'm so glad that we did. And he knew that I loved him. I pray for his family, Mama Sandra. We love you. We appreciate you. We're praying for you. I know this is tough. And Tutu and Tracy, we're praying for you. And I'm sorry that we can't give this huge concert for Troy. Troy was a music lover. And also, I have to also acknowledge his other sister, which is Stephanie. Stephanie Mills, you made his life so full and complete. I remember, I think we all met each other around the same time, and this ain't no joke, he loved you even before he even met you. You were his favorite. And to see that you've become best friends, and when he started singing with you, that was like such an incredible moment for Troy. He loved it and really, really honored you and the time to be able to stand on the stage with you. So when I honor his family, I include you. My last thing that I want to say is the memory that I'll never forget about Troy is I had done a song at West Angeles called I Give You Praise. And it ended really quick. It's a song Richard Smallwood wrote. And I was like, it needs a vamp. It needs something else. And I wrote,
we've come to the end of our sharing on tonight, but we will certainly never come to the end of expressing our love for Troy Clark. For those of you who would like to be a blessing to Troy's family, there's information on the screen that you can avail yourself to so that you can make tangible donations to his family. We all know that Troy has blessed us all in our respective places in very unique ways. This is our time to now honor his legacy by contributing tonight.
It has been said that the greatest use of one's life can be summed up by the impact that life has had on other lives. As we come to the end of our program, we need only to observe all those who contributed this evening and the countless thousands whom Troy has impacted.
You know, in times like these, it requires a God moment.
Yes.
Only God can reach down from heaven and touch our hearts, give us strength, give us comfort, give us a peace that surpasses all understanding. For as believers, we do not mourn as those who have no hope, because we understand that while Troy sleeps now, we will see him again. And when we see him again, it'll be no hurt, no pain, no yes. medicine. Listen, when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing it will be.
May the sweet comfort which the Holy Spirit brings rest upon your hearts and bring the affirmation of the Holy Writ. For we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have another building, a building of God, a house not made with human hands, but eternal in the heavens.
And now, to all the family and friends, and to each of you who have viewed tonight, may the Lord bless you and sustain you.
May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you.
May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.
both now and forevermore. Amen. God bless each of you.
And may God bless the memory of Troy Douglas Clark.
Good night.